Hey guys, it's me again, Rose from the Philippines. Welcome to my show and tell channel called Gantsilyera of crochet and craft related items. Today is November 9, 2019. It's a Saturday, so I'm making an earlier podcast today to show you guys my projects and my recent undertakings. So thank you for taking the time out of your day to visit with me. So today I'm gonna show you some posts and whips that I have been making these past days. The first one that I want to show you is Dudeland, the Hippo. So this is how it turned out. It's very big and cuddly. And for this one, I used the yarn that Ate Fats gave me. Hi Ate Fats! I think it's a variegated ice yarn for the body and the head. I wasn't able to pick this up from before because I was quite apprehensive about how the eye turned out way up to this head part. But the other day I was able to pick it up and continue working on it, like putting the hands, the feet, the ears, and the tails for it just to finish it. I really wanted to finish this so that I can continue on with other projects because it has been on my mind for a while now. So this is how it turned out, and I'm calling him Dudeland from the show that Daniel always watches on YouTube. And I'm asking the kids what they think, what type of animal this is. And Sophie said that it's a hippo, and Marius and Daniel agrees with her. So it became a hippo. I was going to turn it into a pony or some type of horse, and Miss Esme gave me the idea of turning it into a hippo. So I was okay with her idea, so I decided to turn it into one. It turned out like this. Pretty huggable and cute. I was going to adopt this one, but I'm gonna try to sell it on my Shopee account. If you are interested in it, I will put it there. I have an account on an online shop here in the Philippines, and my items are, you can see it there. And if you're interested, I will put the link on the description box below. All of the items are available here in the Philippines. So that is Dudeland the Hippo. That is my first faux, and since I'm into a finishing mode lately, I decided to work on another work dress. And it is this, what I call it is Angela's top, since my chatmate from before and friend requested for it. I think she asked for it last February. But it's just now that I was able to finish it, so it has been on my mind also. So this is how it is, and this is how it turned out. And Stella is wearing it right now. The last time that I've shown you this, I was able to work on the front and back panels for the bottom part of this top. I wasn't able to sew it yet here, so the other day I took the time to do that because I really wanted to finish it. So this is how it turned out. I was quite apprehensive about the length of it, so that is why I keep putting it off. But the other day I just decided to make the front panel as long as the back one, so that I can sew it here by the side and put some edging on it just to finish it. And she requested for this last February and was asking if I can make it so she can use it as a cover for when she is swimming during the summer. But it's just now that I was able to pick it up. And these are using mercerized cotton thread, and I think I have used 6 to 7 bolts of it for this one. So I'm quite happy that I have finished it. For the edging, I didn't do the one from the pattern or from the magazine because I got kind of confused with it on how to work on it. So I decided to just make this edging here. that I just made up. So that is Angela's top, already made. The length that she requested is higher than the knee, a little bit higher, but I think this turned out a little bit more higher than what she has requested, but I think this stretches in time, so it's okay. And I'm gonna also put it on my Shopee account just to add up some items there. So those are the two finishes that I have for you guys. I have another finish, which are the alternate flowers for the headband, the knitted headbands that I am making. So I was able to make the design from my past projects, which is this flower here. This flower has two layers of petals to it, which have five of them. So using the acrylic yarn, it turned out bigger than the one, the sample that I have. So I have this as an alternative for when you wanted to use this one or the other flower that I have made. You just needed to take it off from the button. So I have that one, and I have this. I have a blue one. I have the orange for the brown, and light blue for this rusty colored one. I have this pink here, the violet, and the last one is this one. So I'm gonna put this on my shop. I already have taken a picture of it, and I will put it there as some with some variations, so that you can choose from. If ever you like this flower, you can use it, or if ever you wanted the other one, it's just some added effect for the product that I am offering people. So I have that, and you may have seen my yarn haul from last week. I bought some variegated yarns from Love Knot, some 15 gram balls of each colorway. So I was able to make granny squares out of them. So I have this now. I have made the 11 colorways. I have one that I have already have on my stock or on my stash. So for these projects, I was able to make 3 granny squares out of one whole 15 gram balls. For the third one though, I was playing yarn chicken, because the first one that I made, the whole ball is enough for the 3 squares. But when I'm doing the last round of it, I was running out of yarn, so I needed to tighten my tension just to make sure that I can make the last round for it. So I'm just gonna show you how it turned out, all of them. I think there's just one of them that I made 3 rounds for the third square, and I needed to sew in the ends for this. And what I'm thinking about is for the borders for them, I'm thinking of using a cream colored yarn instead of black, because I've been seeing them on the TV and I'm leaning towards the cream colored for the borderline of this granny squares. This is how it turned out. I think I have 3 more colorways that I didn't buy from their shop. And if you are curious about where I shop this yarns, it is from GST Supply at Tabora Divisoria. I always buy from them because they are very courteous in selling for me. And there are other shops there also where you can buy other type of yarns, but that is my go-to shop. So this one, the third square only has 3 rounds to it. I have little of the yarn left. rounds, so I wasn't able to put another round. So these are variegated yarns that I just experimented with, and I really love working on them these past days as some type of mindless crochet. But this is the last one. So those are the granny squares that I want to show you guys. And another project that I am going to make in the future, I'm gonna continue on making more character purses. I have made some tutorials for, I think, 10 designs of them in the past. If you're interested on working on them, I will put the playlist on the description box below. So I have also been making the base part for the character purses, which are this round crochet piece here. So for this yellow one, I have a request for a smiley type of character, so I'm gonna work on that. I have a blue one lying around, so I decided to make one if ever I want to make a Stitch or an Eeyore from Winnie the Pooh, if I can experiment on that. So I'm using this. And I have another one which is in white for Hello Kitty. Another person or subscriber is asking for that. And yesterday evening, as I was chatting with Miss Jen, hi Miss Jen, someone has asked for one of the daffodils that she has seen as my background, one of the buyers from Shopee. So she asked if I can make her some daffodils. So I have also been making them this morning, and this is the first one that I have made. I have washed the ones that I have here, and it is at our veranda soaking in the sun because it is a little bit sunny today. So I have been working on the trumpets. I needed to work on 10 pieces of them, and I will put them on a vase because she's going to turn it as some decor to her house. So I have this one's made, and I have two more in these colors, and I have this one in this, I don't know if it is a fuchsia pink, but it is some type of pink. So those are the projects that is the order that I have just last night. So I have that to make. And another project, I picked up the lark's foot panels that I'm gonna turn into bags, and I'm gonna work on the back part using this violet yarn here as the back part for this. And then afterwards, I will work on the side and bottom parts along with the strap. This is how I make my bags. Just making some panels for the back and the front part, and then work on the sides. That's how I'm working on my bags that I always wear whenever I go outside. So I think those are most of the projects that I want to show you guys. I have been rummaging the made items, the made crochet pieces that I have. I have a separate drawer for all of them for if I have an idea to continue them on, just like this one. This one is a leftover from when I made some sunflower dream catchers. And I'm planning to make the petals so that I can turn this into one and put it on a rattan ring. Turn it into a dream catcher or a wall hanging as another product to put on or to list on my shop. I'm having some ideas in the future for future projects. And I'm also planning on making more beaded wallets tutorials, and I'm leaning towards making them in Tagalog because several people or subscribers has been asking about that. And these are just some samples that I would like to show you if you are interested that I work on a tutorial for them. The last one is this cylindrical wallet here. Another one is this some type of bag wallet. that I experimented on. This is a flat piece of clusters of six. And I joined it on the side, and it is a little bit tricky and fiddly. But I wanted to try making a tutorial out of them. Another experiment is this one. This is another type of flat clusters that I joined in the side. And since these sides look like ears to me, I've been trying to turn it into a dog. So you can see my effort there. So that is gonna be on future if ever I wanted to continue on making beaded tutorials. So please tune in for that. And I have noticed from one of my podcasts that the comment section has been off. So I needed to manually turn it on. I don't know why it is. Maybe because it is about the new policy of YouTube. If you are experiencing that, please kindly comment on the comment box below. So I think those are most of it. The things that I want to share with you guys. My classmate from high school has been asking about my items, and she has a friend that works as an events organizer. So I have been saying to her that I have small keychains that if she would like to try it out to sell as souvenirs. So that is another happening. So this is becoming long now, so I needed to cut this short so as to upload it well and faster. So I hope you guys have a fine day today. I took the privilege today to make a video because I think it would be there won't be enough time for me tomorrow. So it's nice catching up with you guys. I hope you have a lovely day and some crafting time, and as I always say, some family bonding time. That's it from me. Bye for now.